Hey, good morning. Good morning. This is Israel Wendy, and I'm gonna be playing some gospel music. Hey, Terry, how are you? How are you? I'm trying to get this to turn around, but anyway, here's the temperature. It's a little over 50, and oh man, I tell you, it looks horrendous out there. It's raining. I got my plants out there that look like they're half dying. They're supposed to have little flowers on them, but anyway, I still got my snow blower out because you never know in New York State. So anyway, let's turn this around and get some music going. Hey, here I am, Israel Wendy, and anyway, we'll get some music going. If you got, yeah, Sparkle Hearts, isn't that cool? It's hashtag Summit Live and you get those little sparkle hearts. So thanks for the hearts. We're gonna start out, and I don't know why, but I always love this song to start out in. Oh boy, I lost it already here. The song, I had everything all set up and now it's all. It starts with an H. There it is. Hezekiah Walker. I always like to start out with this song because it gets you going in the morning. So God bless you. Hey Jason, how are you? I'm gonna start my painting. Yes. Yes, hallelujah. Praise God. Here we go. Every word of worship. Welcome to the broadcast. Thank you for the hearts. Thank you for the shares. You guys need to catch Jason at night there. Put up some hearts. Put up some emojis, I mean, not hearts. So, yeah, you can give hearts too. Praise God. Yes. Follow this man. He has got an awesome scope. Wow. I tell you, his scope is awesome. It's so professional looking, not like me. But anyway, we're gonna finish up this painting today. I gotta arrange it here. There we go. That's better. Every praise. Yes. Every praise is to our God. I've been kind of eyeing this color. I have not used it yet. Hey, Jason. Hey, Terry. You guys have some awesome scopes. I tell you, check out the JesusDidIt.org and you can find some great scopes on there. Yes, JesusDidIt.org. Now, like I said, I was eyeing this color. I have not used it because I don't know. This is a little sketchy here. Yes, Jason, just listen to the music. Don't have an accident. Oh, I'm an X-ray tech, so I see what happens when people are distracted and driving. So we're going to put in. We're going to put the cross in here. I think I might have to put a little black in that to make it show up better here. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. I'm trying to make this look like kind of like a tree, not like a. Make it look woodsy here. And what did I do with the rest of my brushes? Every praise to our God. I hope you guys are worshiping. Oh, this is an awesome song. I don't get enough of this song, I tell ya. I'm going to highlight this on the side here so it looks like the orange from the sky is coming through. Hallelujah! Woohoo! I hope this gets you going this morning. Wow. Yes, he's worthy of all our praise. Praise God. Hallelujah. Every praise is to our God. Every praise, every gonna keep the excitement going here. We gotta stir ourselves up in Christ. Yes. This Kirk Franklin, that's called Silver and Gold. Hallelujah, Jesus. Welcome to the broadcast. Silver and gold. I'd rather have Jesus than silver and gold. Your fame or thought, your riches untold. No, I'm getting paint on my camouflage jacket here. Yes, we can always find Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, that's right. I have to have music while I'm cleaning too. My back was hurting really bad and I was trying to do my dishes up. And I had to sing Amazing Grace through the whole, all the work I was doing because my back hurt so bad. And it really helped. I mean, God is so good. God is so good to us. All right, I got some green there in the cross. It almost weather-beaten cross here. Yes, hallelujah. Yes. Yes, hallelujah. Praise God. This is Benjamin Dubé. It's called Holy Spirit. Hey, Kat, how are you this morning? Hey, I caught your scope the other day. I loved that about the Savage Woods. That was such an awesome scope. And I'm actually thinking about those exotic woods today as I'm making these crosses because I want to make them look like, they have a wood grain in them. I don't want them to just be little figures, you know. I want them to come alive here. So even though I was almost done with this picture, I wanted to take a lot of time on the cross. And that was a good scope. I love that wood. That is awesome. And to put himself in danger like that. Uh-oh. For some reason, the music stopped. And oh, it looks like I didn't download the whole song. Well, that's sad. I'll play another song by Benjamin Dubé or Dubois or however you say that. Yes, I would pray nonstop too. Yes, hallelujah. So I'm putting some wood grain into these crosses here so they don't look. Whoops. Sorry, my reach here. I'm not using my left hand today. I'm using my right hand. And I can use both hands. Oh, what are you making good to eat? Hey Kat, I want to do another. Oh, yummy. I woke up in the middle of the night with a horrible headache. And I was thinking about making some bacon and eggs. Kind of like comfort food. I've been waking up a lot lately with headaches and headaches throughout the day. I haven't really prayed much about it, you know, what's going on. But a friend of mine called me yesterday, and he's a renowned prophet, and I know that people tend not to believe prophets nowadays, but he goes, "Wendy, I gotta pray for you." So he prayed for me, and he prayed for my headaches, and when he was done, I was like, "How did you know?" He says, "It's the Holy Spirit," and I'm glad to see that there are people that give due where due is due. You know what I mean? We can't do anything without the Holy Spirit and without God. I think I might make this a little bit lighter. Yes, we definitely need. We need all the fruits of the Spirit. Some people want to deny the gifts. They don't want this gift and they don't want that gift. I tell you, I want all of God I can get. And you know, Kat, I was thinking about what you said, that if you go by the title apostle, that you better be doing miracles. But I went through a season where through prayer, my prayers were being answered. I mean, there was I was praying with some friends in New Zealand, and it hadn't rained in 3 years, and their sheep were dying. And the one lady was crying on the phone with me, and we prayed, and two or three people said that it had started raining. And I mean, the move of the Holy Spirit is just incredible, and I mean, that shocked me. It really shocked me how even, you know, and she didn't even want to pray for her sheep because, you know, she thought that, and I told her, God cares about everything. God cares about everything that we care about. I'm making this a little lighter through here because that's the sun side. I gotta watch this because I'm tipping my board there. I didn't realize how easy it tips. I'm sorry, I didn't see your comment there. Sorry. But God cares about the things that we care about. He really does. He knows the desires of our hearts. I gotta do another cat scope. I gotta use your CD again. Maybe I'll do that on Thursday, Cat, because I really love your music. You have an awesome voice. Like I say, you sound like Carole King to me. And I love Carole King. I love her music. I don't know if she's a Christian or not, but I know that Bob Dylan became a Christian, and I actually went to one of his concerts. Oh my gosh, I loved Bob Dylan. Yeah, yes, it is romantic music. This is Benjamin Dubois, and he has several brothers that sing with him. Let's see what else. This is called The Wedding Song, so let's find out what that's about. This is C.C. Winus. I love this music. I'm just adding paint on a little at a time because it's really wet. Maybe my brushes didn't dry good before. Because I got a brush conditioner yesterday and I started using it. Some of my brushes were getting kind of stiff. I wanted to draw this painting and do windmills, but that's not. Hey, welcome, Freeze Frost. Oh, we get a lot of Freeze Frost around here. I gotta touch up the sunlight there a little bit, because I got some of the orange bleeding through and I don't like it. Boy, she's got an awesome voice. Wow, that's a bright yellow. Especially with my 100-watt kitchen bulbs there. But I love color. I love bright colors. God made bright colors. I'm gonna paint some smaller paintings and give them out for my birthday. Hey, Jason, you're back? I was telling Kat that I watched her scope with her one son there that has the Savage Woods. Oh my gosh, that wood was so beautiful. And so I want to do a wood texture on these crosses. Yes, they were beautiful. Oh my gosh. I don't know what I would use them for, you know? That would show off how beautiful they are. God is just amazing. I'm just trying to round this out a little bit here so it doesn't look oblong or whatever. Oh, the music stopped. When the music fades. Oh. Let's see.
Been traveling these white roads for so long. My heart's been far from you. 10,000 miles gone. Oh, I want to come near and give you every part of me. But there's blood on my hands and my lips are clean. In the darkness, I remember.
There's a song you like, you can request it. I can download it. I have a hyper program that you can download just about any song in any format you want to. It's temperamental, the program, but it works good when it's working. No commercials, no... Yellow is my mom's favorite color.
As a woman with many crimes, come up for air as my sin flows down the chain.
Thank you. Thank you, Tibbs. It's all Holy Spirit because I really do not have. How old is my mom? Oh, she's almost 77. So that tells you how old I am. I'm in my 50s. I had somebody the other day ask me if I was in my 30s. I says, oh, I wish. I got a little bit of paint left on my brush here. I didn't put any of that soap in my water, so I'm gonna have fun. Just putting a little shadow on my crosses here. Hallelujah. I want to go to the river. Yes, hallelujah. Yes, I appreciate my poor mom. She has very hard time dealing with stress. And
hallelujah.
So I pray quite often for her. She is a Christian. She's been through a lot, my mom. She was diagnosed with multiple myeloma, and they only gave her a few months to live. And our church got together. Several of us started praying for her over the weekend. And her next doctor's appointment, they could not find any of the multiple myeloma at all. They could not find one sign of it. The doctors were shocked. And they even repeated all the tests. They repeated all the expensive PET scan and the only thing that they found was that she had a tumor in her stomach that was highly curable. And it was funny because the first thing my mom said was, well, God healed me from everything else. Why didn't he heal that tumor in my stomach? And she found out because as she was going to chemo, she was able to minister to a lot of people. And, you know, she and several people that I knew from where she was going to chemo, because I work in the medical field, they told me that she was like a light in that place, that she was inspiration to a lot of people. And her testimony of being healed. Was really inspiring to a lot of people. And, you know, a lot of people may not have accepted Christ as their Savior, but the seeds were planted. The seeds were planted. Because they saw how real God was. They saw God work in a real way. So we, you know, it's like I said before, it's not about the numbers. It's not about how many people that you save or you lead to salvation. It's not about the numbers. It's about, you know, the planting the seeds and making disciples. Some people, their calling in life is to uplift Christians. Because Christians get down and Christians get discouraged. I know I do. And, you know, that is, God has a calling for each of us. And His plans are way above our plans, I'll tell you. If somebody told me a couple of months ago that I would be painting, I would have laughed at them because I can't even draw. My drawings are like stick figures. And yet the Holy Spirit led me to start painting. And God gave me the time. God gave me the time to start painting because I've only been painting about a month. I started probably the end of February. I started to paint. And yes, I do have an uncle that's a painter, but I'm not close with that uncle. And he never taught me how to paint or anything like that. So, although I think that maybe I should be ministering to him because he's a, you know, him and my father were claimed to be atheists, although my father is now saved. My father claimed for years to be an atheist, and one day I asked him why. And he said, because if there was a God, God would not allow all this suffering to happen. And I know a lot of people feel that way, but God loves us. He doesn't allow suffering. But He says there will be suffering because of sin in the world. This is called Forever Jones, and Bless the Lord. What am I going to call this painting? I don't know because I have never actually entitled my paintings. I'll quickly show you the my previous paintings that I've done. And like I said, I've only been painting about a month. And I just finished this one. And before that, I did this one. As you can tell, I like color. And this was another one that I did with the moon. And I tried to copy all the things that are on the moon, but I don't know if I succeeded or not. And then there's this one. And this one's got glitter on it. So I've been pretty busy. This right here is like one of my first ones. And so I've progressed. And this one right here, I actually copied from my calendar. That's on my calendar. But yeah, I haven't been painting very long. And my one friend, yeah, and the dog one too. Yeah, that's out in the living room. My dog picture. Yes, I do love my dog. She's been such a blessing. I literally helped bring her into the world. Because at the time that she was born, I had 14 Boston Terriers. I had a kennel. And of course, I was living in sin. I was living with my boyfriend at the time. And he was not a Christian. And that became a very depressing situation because I knew I was doing wrong. I knew that that's not what God wanted for me. So I left him and I made a clean break of him. Hey, Rick, how are you? I'm playing some gospel music this morning. Rick, put up some emojis. People have got to follow your scope. That's an awesome scope. Rick Costa, he's on Periscope because I know I upload these to YouTube and to Facebook as well, but Rick Costa is on Periscope or Twitter, whichever. Yes, look at, I have sparkles on my heart. Hallelujah. Yeah, I hope it's not freezing up. I've got a new phone and I turn off all my other items that are taking Wi-Fi away. So I do have the lowest grade Wi-Fi that, because I'm paying over $100. What is a Christian? Well, a Christian is one that believes in Christ. And if you're a Christian, the love of Jesus is in you. You believe in Christ. And you read the Bible. And it's all about relationship. It's not about, it's not necessarily about just going to church. Because there's a lot of people that go to church that aren't Christian. And yeah, it's a changed life. I'll tell you, I was just, earlier I was talking about how I had a kennel and I was living in sin. I was living with my boyfriend. And the Holy Spirit convicted me that this was not the way to live, that I was depressed. I was living with someone that had a very negative personality. And I mean, he had nothing good to say about most people. And because of that, there were certain relationships that were forever tainted because all I heard was his negativity. And like, for instance, he would, and I'm not going to say his name or anything like that. And I've forgiven him. I really have. But I'm using this as an example to minister to someone that may be feeling that they are in a relationship with someone that is negative. And because of that, I tried and helped him. Yeah, he said that if I came back to him, that he would accept Christ and start going to church with me. And I told him, I says, you can't do that. I says, you have to yourself want to change your life. You have to for yourself, not for me. It's just like people that are on alcohol or drugs, they can't do it for somebody else. They have to make the initial action to want to get off the drugs, want to stop the alcohol. They have to want to do that, and it has to be a desire from them. Yes, I did love him, but I had to give him up because he was destroying me with his negativity. And like I said, it destroyed other relationships because he would say negative things about other people, and especially his father. And after his father died, the whole thing turned around and he said, oh, I love my father. And it was terrible because I had missed out having a relationship with his father because all I heard was the negative. All I heard was negative, negative, negative. And that's kind of like how it is with Satan. Satan tells us that we're no good. Satan tells us that you know, we're unworthy, that we don't deserve love. Satan goes on, no, he didn't hurt me, really. He was, you know, negative. He did indirectly hurt me. I'll say it was a mental kind of thing, because he would say that our relationship depended on how I acted towards his son, and that was very hard. His son was very violent, tried to stab me with a knife, ran me over, my foot over with a car, you know, things like that. And my ex-boyfriend was always saying, "Well, you deserved it." And no, I do not deserve that. That's not something that I deserve. We deserve much better. God loves us. God loves us. God loves us in the place where we're at right now. That doesn't mean that we have to clean ourselves up. That doesn't mean that we have to stop drinking and all that. 'Cause God can meet us where we are. God loves us. He sent his only son to die on the cross for us because he loved us and he wanted us to be able to be free from that depression, free from the negativity, free from our guilt, free from our the other addictions that we have in our life. And yes, there are a lot of rules and regulations in the Bible, but Jesus died so that he covered those rules so that now the Holy Spirit can prompt us and tell us, hey, what you're doing is not right. And if we just listen to the Holy Spirit, if we listen to that Holy Spirit, that consciousness within us, we will, live a better life. We will not get into a lot of the situations that we shouldn't be getting into. And it's hard. It's very hard to cut people off. It's hard to, people that you love that you know are not good for you. It's hard to get rid of, It is really hard. Yeah, life is very hard. I know it's hard. I can't imagine now the things that I've gone through without Jesus, without that hope that I can have a better future. Because this life is short. This life is like a wisp compared to eternity. And I know that it's going to be so much better. It's going to be so much better in the future. I mean, right now, I'm not working. I'm not sure of my future at work. I'm not sure if I'm going to have a job. And I have a peace about that. Yes, I get discouraged. And sometimes I do worry a little bit, but it's only a fleeting worry. It's not like I'm losing sleep over it or anything. My highlight kind of darkened as it. Wow, what a voice. Uh-oh, my thing is tipping again. I gotta put some weight on it. And I'm trying to put like a wood grain on these crosses because it's kind of weather beaten here. Let it rain. Hope And I kind of wanted to talk today about the prayer of Jabez and how he overcame his name. I just naturally took it up, Tibbs. How are you? I don't know what I'm doing. I'm using cheap paint. I'm using... I can't even draw. I actually bought the charcoals to do some drawing, and I just can't. I just cannot draw. And I only started this... Sunlight Over Salvation, that's a good one. Yeah, I just started like a month ago. And although, you know, I have an uncle that's an artist. He's been an artist for many years. But I never really watched him paint or anything like that. And I don't think he does much painting anymore. But... Open the floodgates. Let it rain down. Hallelujah. Yes, I'm using canvas. I was using stretch canvas, but this is the board. Welcome. Welcome, Art. And I'm actually using several different brands of paint, and some of the paintbrushes I have are the Crayola paintbrushes. So God bless your day. Thank you for joining me. Make sure that... catch me tomorrow. I have different music going on tomorrow. I'll just be playing contemporary Christian music tomorrow. And possibly Thursday, I'm going to be using Kat Ello's CD in the background. She's an awesome scoper. Make sure that you catch Kat Ello's scope. You can follow her on Periscope. And so remember what I always say, and I got to find my little sticky note here. That, see that circle? That is you. That's your personal space, that little circle right there. You are adored, you are blessed, and you are loved by God. You are loved. And that's what you should be letting into your circle, that you should be letting into your personal space, the knowledge that you are adored, blessed, and loved. Don't let depression in. Don't let frustration in. Don't let guilt and condemnation and shame, because that is no longer you. You are covered in the blood of Jesus. And if you do not know Jesus today, I have my website on my profile. If you do not know Jesus today, get a hold of me. Get a hold of me through Facebook. Get a hold of me on Periscope, or you know, watch these scopes, and we'll talk. So God bless your day. I hope that today that you will find somebody that you can bless and carry on that love. Just give the love out. Be an ambassador of Christ, because this world is so full of hate, so full of bitterness, and so full of violence, that to show somebody some love, to show somebody the love of Jesus, it could be
It could be the breaking point. It could be the way that they can come to know Christ as their Savior. Even just so, show some charity. Show kindness. You don't have to be preachy. You don't have to be religious. Just show love. And remember, you are adored, you are blessed, and you are loved by God. Praise God. I'll see you guys tomorrow. God bless you. This